Then we disrupt it, and we get 0 here. If they don't want to change it, So in this picture, we have a very nice representation of the metal space. They draw here. So what happens here, mathematically, we can quickly see as follows. We have a three dimensional configuration space. We have, say it's x in, y in, and z p. So x and y, we think about two ways that they are trying to move around, and z is about where the decoding moves around. They have a wave function, a plane wave, coming in from here. Okay. So around the point of interaction to the Fourier transform, we're going to have two waves, the front the one in which is going to be like this. One in which is going to move down. So we'll go from two-dimensional configuration space to three-dimensional configuration space, in which there are going to be two distinct parts of the wave function spreading in space. Now, so because this two-part wave function is far away, there's not going to be constructive different configurations between the two parts. All of this, where when you have interaction point here, they both have interference in the same way. That's the difference between this picture and this picture, when interference kind of is lost here. And as the reliability of that becomes lower, you can see this becoming closer, they'll be producing more interference. But given a perfectly reliable indicator, we're going to have two distinct parts of the wave function being non-interfering onto each other. So this is the example I'm focused on now, because it illustrates the quantum measure problem very nicely. So when we have the wave function system, so V1 plus V2 and say phi of the monitor P. So we know that if we have this say sine 1 going to the upper slope, then we measure up. If you're going to go to the lower slope, you'll measure down. So we need to find this stuff. Okay. Can you see here? Yeah, okay. So the first back note is that suppose sine B and then we have say the wait, this is the monitor, it is 5 ready. Plus by indicates. Also, we know that it is psi e down and phi ready. We're going to evolve to psi e down and phi indicates down. Really in here, right? So when we combine these two together, but the inherent equation, we have this one. So we just have two parts. We just phi ready. So we evolve to psi up and phi indicates up plus psi down and phi indicates. So by the wave function involving the Maxwellian equation, we have this result of this graph. But that's actually inconsistent with combination. We can put it down as alpha of this graph, namely it's either up or down. And in the case up from last year, we can get down from last year. And this is not in case up, where it's not. It's consistent of two constant wave function. So what we have here is a simple illustration of the conflict between amount three positions. Right here, the natural form. So if the wave function completely describes the physical system, then position 1 is the one that is everything. The second, it will always obey the linear Schrödinger equation, naturally it's always exact, universal, it's not only the moving parts, but also the rapid moving, the system, and the device. Then we have the second position, Schrödinger equation is universal and exact. But given these two positions, we have the following prediction, namely that this will be the end result of this error, not particularly up indicator or down indicator. So this is why it's in conflict with the following third position, the outcomes of this error are down. Right, up, down, left, right. Okay. So the three positions are in conflict, not bad. And the way to go is not to give us a classical logic or computer theory, but you think whether we give up any one of the three positions. So the one remains, I'm going to briefly mention one strategy to solve the Mandel problem.
Namely, do you have to take a second subset for this? Possibly the exit.
That's right, yeah, maybe not to solve your problem. But we can still first try to see if you give up this one, give up this one, give up this one. So by the way, let me mention that if you give up this one, you have extra features, extra homologies, particles, fields, what have you. And one particular version is called Bohmian mechanics. If I involve your ball. So they have the wave function, and also you have particles of basic speed. You have actual particles, which reside on basis that move according to the function. The second strategy is to give up the universality of exactness of Schrödinger equation, give up running to something called the GLW. Boom, this is a mechanics. It's a different way third one is the unevenness picture of Abbott. We deny that there is no black hole on the surface. They follow the real substance. The main world prediction in which they the only undisciplined which you see is not, but the best one which you see is not. So, three propositions. What can you three always deny due to give up something kind of essentially standard hypothesis? And we focus on this one first. So it's hard to pin down exactly what Copenhagen says because the Copenhagen prediction is kind of a collection of sayings or Heisenberg, Pauli, others. It's not always consistent. So what I understand this, I think, is that there's no magical starting world. So it's foolish and it's hopeless.